In the book of Jeremiah in the Old Testament, we find a fascinating account about how a prophet learns a powerful message. The word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, "Arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause thee to hear my words." Then I went down to the potter's house, and behold, he wrought a work on the wheels. And the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter. So he made it again, another vessel, as seemed good to the potter to make it. Before we read what the prophet learned from this experience, I invite you to listen with spiritual ears to hear what you might learn as I walk you through the steps for making a bowl using pottery. Basically, I'm going to walk you through the steps that Jeremiah saw when he went to the potter's house. Clay comes in large quantities and it needs to be cut down, weighed, and kneaded in a process called wedging. This can be done with a tool called a pugger or by hand, but in both cases, the clay is smashed down and cut into the right size. Then it's slapped into a roundish shape. The process removes all imperfections of the clay, any part that's hardened or unworkable, and any air pockets that would ruin the piece. On the pottery wheel, we begin every piece exactly the same way. The clay is centered. It needs to be in the exact center or the piece cannot be thrown properly. Time is taken to cone the clay up and press it back down as many times as is needed to get the clay exactly centered. Without this solid foundation, nothing else the potter does will matter. The piece will be wasted. The potter knows what the clay will become, so after it's centered, he works the clay into the proper shape. Sometimes the clay is pressed down. Other times it's transformed into a tall cylinder. It's often unclear through the entire process what the potter has in mind for the clay until the wheel stops. Even after the piece is taken off the wheel, it can be carved, sculpted, or it could have handles or spouts added. It is never over until the potter is satisfied with the piece. Sometimes a piece of pottery needs to be thrown into the trash bucket. This can happen at any phase of the creation before it's been fired. A piece can fall apart while it's on the wheel and it's still soft, or a piece might be looking great and the handle falls off after it's nearly complete or air dried. But the life of the clay is not over at this point. The trash bucket is taken and soaked until all the clay is softened. Then it's mixed together and dried to the point where it can be kneaded and used again. When clay is reconstituted in this way, it is just as good as it ever was. It can become anything, a plate, a bowl, a cup, a vase, a teapot, anything. The clay has just as much possibility and potential now as it did when it was brand new. This is what Jeremiah witnessed when he went to the potter's house. Think about what you might have learned if you had witnessed this experience. Now, here is what the Lord wanted Jeremiah to learn. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, "O house of Israel, cannot I do with you as this potter, saith the Lord? Behold, as the clay is in the potter's hand, so are ye in mine hand, O house of Israel." Although he is speaking specifically about the nation of Israel at this point, I think it's also a very personal message to all those who believe in him. Jesus Christ is the master potter. We are the clay. Life in all its uncertainty, unpredictability, unfairness, often cruelty, is the process that we're going through to become what he wants us to become. When we're humble, he can shape us into becoming more than we could ever become on our own, and there is more. When the potter is satisfied with the creation, the next step is to make it a forever pot. The process of finishing the pot is called glazing. The pot is fired, glazed, and then fired again. Firing pottery is a process that burns out every ounce of moisture. It shrinks the pot to its final size and fundamentally changes the pottery down to its chemical level. This is a process called vitrification. After the first firing, glaze is added, then the pottery is fired for the final time. This process seals the clay under a layer of glass. It strengthens it and adds beauty that transforms it into something greater than it could ever be expected. The pot is now completed, and it can be used how the master sees fit.